Meantime, stakeholders and analysts have criticized government's reactionary approach to abductions and insecurity in the country. With the criminals responsible for the abduction in Kagera, Niger State demanding a 500 million naira ransom to release the victims. The question arises, how long will Nigerians suffer? Plus TV Africa's correspondent Destiny Momo reports.
The abduction of over 40 people, including students, teachers and non-teaching staff members from an all-boys government science college, GSE, in Kagera town, Niger State, between Tuesday night and Wednesday morning has dominated discourse on the airwaves non-stop. For this tide to turn, analysts say governments must be proactive.
I would call on Mr. President to immediately convene the National Security Council, expand the membership of that council to include the governor and the leadership of the National Assembly.
Kagera abduction, I felt very bad, like any other Nigerian. I felt sad, and I began to also feel again that till now, I mean, we are the same country making investors not to come.
For a state of emergency to be declared, I think there is a need for clarification. In security parlance, when you ask for a state of emergency, it means you are saying that the democratic institutions should be put on hold or suspended. In other words, levels like the governor and then several other democratic levels will now be put on hold to allow the president to take full control and, you know, carry out such actions that this suspended level will delay.
Recently, the Minister of Defense, Bashiru Magashi, asked Nigerians to summon courage and defend themselves when attacked. This has generated diverse reactions.
As a security expert who is studying terrorism and counterterrorism across the world, I know that a critical component of counterterrorism is for the communities that are being affected to develop resilience. The best way to develop that resilience is through community efforts. So if that is what the minister meant, then yes. But I think he needs to clarify what he meant by that.
I totally agree with the minister. What he did was he was proverbial, really, when he was talking about that. But that statement he was making is the product of intelligence. And that aspect of the intelligence probably was something after they dissect the thinking of the ordinary Nigerian.
The threat from banditry has become complicated by an increased association with jihadists who are still waging an 11-year-old insurgency in Nigeria's northeast. To this end, experts say understanding the peculiarity of each region is key.
In the northeastern flank of the country, what you have are terrorists. And terrorism is really hitting that flank of the country seriously. When you come to the northwestern part of the country, what you are experiencing is clearly banditry. And when you start cascading towards the central part, you know, and what you are going to see there is kidnapping. And between you and I, they are all different.
Northern Nigeria has long been bedeviled by terrorism, kidnapping, and banditry. It is hoped that the emergence of new service chiefs will bring respite to this region and the nation at large. Destiny Momo for Plus TV Africa.
Hello, hope you enjoyed the news. Please do subscribe to our YouTube channel and don't forget to hit the notification button so you get notified about fresh news updates.